David here with Fig Boot on Pens. Today I have for you a pen that I've previously reviewed from Diplomat, but it's a brand new color and one that I was very excited about from the first time I saw it at the Atlanta Pen Show. And that pen is the Diplomat Arrow in Sunset Orange. What I'm going to do is go over the parts and features of the Arrow, talk about what I care for and what I don't care for, show some measurements, size comparisons, and provide a writing sample. And then stay tuned to the end of the review to learn how you can win this pen courtesy of Points of Distinction, the exclusive U.S. importer of Diplomat fountain pens who provided this pen for both review and for giveaway. And then they also provided a generous discount code for you that you could use on their site for the month of July 2017. So I'll let you know about that as well. Now, I've reviewed a few Diplomats, the Arrow, and then two different versions of the Excellence A, one in Rhombus Guilloche, and then the other in Skyline Blue. Now, in those reviews, I go into detail about Diplomat's company history and more into the symbolism behind their ink flower logo and things like that, so I'm not going to repeat that info here. If you're interested in hearing more about that, you can check out those previous reviews. The pen comes in this box. I do like Diplomat's packaging. I think it looks pretty sharp. They have this metal top that slides off, and then underneath we have a little flap. And then underneath the flap we have the use and care guide, as well as two standard international converters. And then we have the pen, the Diplomat Arrow in Sunset Orange. This Arrow comes in four different colors, black and white and brown, and then this sunset orange. I really fell in love with this color the moment I saw it. The first thing that it reminded me of was the Lamy's limited edition All-Star from a couple years ago, this copper orange here, which is one of my very favorite colors of any pen in my collection. I just think it looks really cool. And it does look somewhat similar to that. The Arrow is made from an anodized aluminum. Anodizing is an electromechanical process that converts the surface of a metal into a durable, kind of corrosion-resistant material that is that can have a decorative matte finish. I just like the feeling of this pen. Let's start here at the finial. On the end here is the Maltese cross-inspired ink flower logo on black metal. Then we have the clip, which I really like on the Arrow. It's matte black and longer than on most pens. It does have a decent amount of spring to it, and the overall shape of the Arrow is very Zeppelin-esque. There are 16 elongated grooves on both the cap and the barrel that, along with this matte finish, give the Arrow a very distinctive feel in your hand. The grooves actually help reduce the overall weight of this metal pen while maintaining the size. I really enjoyed distinct pens like this, ones that you could recognize by touch alone, or a nib you recognize with your eyes closed. The Arrow is one of those pens. The cap actually tapers up and then doesn't have a traditional band, but there is a smooth area here where the grooves don't extend on both the barrel and the cap. In this space, it is engraved with Diplomat and made in Germany. One thing that I did notice is that on previous versions of the Arrow, the band text was actually printed on the Sunset Orange model here, that it's engraved. Now, I've never had any issues with the printing coming off on previous versions, but having it engraved eliminates even the possibility of that happening. The transition between the cap and the barrel is virtually flush, and then the barrel tapers down to a rather pointed, rounded end, which is black to match the finial. The cap snaps off to reveal this very nice steel nib. I really like the size of this nib. The Arrow isn't the largest pen, so I can understand if it had a smaller nib, but having a number 6 size nib on here really works well, in my opinion. It's a nice surprise. Now, this is what their steel nib looks like, and then this is what their two-toned 14-karat gold nib looks like. And then here's a look at the plastic feet. The end of the section is grooved, and then angles up to a rather steep angled transition to the barrel. The section is metal, but it is not slick at all. The matte finish really helps you grip the pen with no issues. Plus, I just really like the feeling of that matte finish. It's something different than acrylic or resin or slick metal on other pens. The cap does post. You know, I can't say that it does post that securely, though. At times, it can get a bit loose. Now, even though this is a metal pen, I don't feel that using it posted really backweights this pen at all, but I prefer to use it unposted. And for me, the barrel is plenty long enough to use unposted without any issues. The Aero is a cartridge converter pen. It does come with a converter and accepts standard international cartridges, two of which were included in the pen as you saw earlier. Now, I know this is something small, but I really like the way the pen feels when you are screwing and unscrewing the barrel. It's just machined very well with very low tolerances. It just has a nice feel to it. It's really well made. Now, you might have noticed when I was showing the nibs that I have two of these pens. Hillary and Larry from Points of Distinction provided this pen to me at the Atlanta Pen Show, and I knew right away that I wasn't going to like having to give this one away. So I purchased another one for myself. And while the Diplomat steel nibs are outstanding, I have another Aero with a steel nib, so I decided to have this one come with one of their 14 karat gold nibs. In regard to the difference between the gold and the steel nibs, their steel nibs are fantastic. They are very smooth and one of my favorite steel nibs in my entire collection. The gold nib is very good as well. It's a bit on the firm side for a gold nib, but performs very nicely. For me, the steel nib has a higher wow factor because it's really that good. It's a good value for the money. The Aero retails for $195. If you would like a gold nib, then that brings the cost up to $295. For a bit less, it's also available in a mechanical pencil, a rollerball, and a ballpoint. If you'd like to check out the Aero on the Points of Distinction website, you can check on the link below in the notes. And for the month of July of 2017, if you use the code FIGBOOTS717, it will give you a 20% site-wide discount on any purchase. Using that code actually brings the base price of the Aero down to $156, which is a great price for this pen with a steel nib, and $236 for the gold nib, which again is a great deal for a gold nib on a very nice pen. Either option are a very good value for the money. If you would like to win this very pen, courtesy of Points of Distinction, just leave a comment here on YouTube. Today is Saturday, July 1st, 2017, and you have until the end of day on July 4th to enter. In regard to a comment topic, I think this Sunset Orange was a great addition to the Aero lineup. Let me know what other pen models, Diplomat or any other brand that you can think of that you would like to see come out in a different color. You know, I have two that I'd love to see. I'd love to see a Pelican 1000 in the blue stripe. I would get one of those in a second. And then also I think if Lamy was to come out with some colored versions of the Macrolon 2000, I think they would have a really hard time keeping those in stock. I mean, how cool would a copper orange 2000 look? Very cool, I would say. So now it's time for some measurements, size comparisons, and a writing sample. So here we go with some size comparisons for the Diplomat Aero in the Sunset Orange color. First of all, here it is next to the black Diplomat. Then I showed it previously, but this is the Lamy All-Star in the copper orange. And then here is a Twisby VAC 700 with some orange ink in it. Then in regard to some other orange pens, here it is with a Visconti Manhattan Magma. Then here it is with a Delta Dolce Vita Stantufo Oro. And then finally, here it is with a Visconti Rembrandt. So here we go with the writing sample for the Diplomat Aero. And this one has a fine steel nib. And the ink that we're using today is Pilot Namiki Blue. And this is what the bottle looks like. I kind of like that bottle. It's kind of a cool looking bottle, just kind of rounded there. And then this is what the actual ink looks like. It's a, you know, it's a lighter shade of blue. It's somewhat similar to something like the Lamy Blue or even the Monteverde Blue. It's just more on the paler side of blue as opposed to the more saturated blues. But still, nice. So here we go with the writing sample. This is a fine steel nib, and I mentioned it before, but the Diplomat nibs are outstanding. I typically have the mediums that I use, but I decided to try the fine on this one, and I like it. It's nice. It's it is not too toothy. It's decently smooth, but it gives a decent fine line. Now, you know, you're not going to get too much flex out of there. And it's not, I wouldn't say it's the wettest in regard to flow, but then again, it's mainly because it's a fine nib. In regard to reverse writing, it doesn't look like it's working that well. On this fine nib, doesn't seem like reverse writing is its thing. Now, you know what, just to compare, this is the gold nib, and this is a gold medium nib. And so in the gold medium nib, you can get a bit more flex out of there. And, well, let me start a little lighter, a little heavier. You can get a decent amount of flex in here. And the gold medium, I wouldn't still categorize it as a very wet nib. But still not the greatest in regard to reverse writing. Not that I use that a lot, but and not that that's a measure of a good nib or not. There, it started writing a little bit more. Now, back to the fine in regard to some fast writing. It performs just fine. So, you know, the Diplomat Aero is a, you know, a very good pen at a reasonable price. It's on my top 10 list of pens between $100 and $250. And so I think it'll be very hard to knock this pen off this list. So, thanks again. Go out to Points of Distinction. For the donation of this pen, for review and for giveaway, and that you want to check out their site in the links below, and don't forget to use the 20% discount code of FigBoot 717. And you're going to use that for the entire month of July, and that's July of 2017. And that's a site-wide discount, so not only the Aero, but anything else you want to pick up on that site. It's something I'd highly recommend. So, thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you later.